All right, check those markets. Why not? Because the Dow's come back from a nasty, better than 100-point loss, and are now down 60 points. The Nasdaq is actually up. Market guy of the day is David Barnson, and he joins us now. David, I want to talk to you about Biden's tax plan, because I read your stuff, and you say it's really going to hurt small businesses. Tell me more.
Yeah, the caveat I want to offer, Stuart, is I'm not sure he'll be able to get this through. So what they've proposed, we have to look at differently than what the final legislation will be. And that's where the 50-50 Senate thing and the very tight lead in the House comes in. Because one of the things he proposed is taking back the 20% deduction on net income that owners of LLCs, S corporations, partnerships, sole proprietorships, these are what we call pass-through entities. And so they're not corporations, they're a different type of structure of a business that's normally for a small business, family business, different type of enterprise. Well, because there was a big corporate tax cut in 2017, to offer the same type of deal without it being a penalty to small business, they offered this 20% deduction on that income. Well, Stuart, this is over $1 trillion a year of income that passes through to owners' personal tax returns from these businesses. President Biden suggesting getting rid of that. That, to me, is a far more expensive thing to our economy than raising the corporate tax rate, which I don't want that to happen either. Right. But it's very clear to me now they're not going to be able to get it all the way to 28%. Five Democrat senators are saying they're going to hold the line at 25. And when you factor in greater deductibility for R&D expenses, I actually think a lot of companies won't have their taxes go up at all. So the big corporate tax side, I think, is more bark than bite. But small businesses is what I'm really focused on.
Well, well done. That's brought something in very important to our attention, and we appreciate that. Now, normally, David, when you're on this program, you recommend strong dividend plays. You like companies where the dividend is strong and growing. You brought two today. First off, Gilead Sciences, which I think yields about 4%, and IBM 5%. Is that right?
Close enough, yes. And with Gilead, I've been on your show talking about it last year because they were at the forefront of this remdesivir treatment, which was a huge part of therapeutic around COVID-19. And somehow along the way, we had owned the stock before COVID, before anyone had ever heard of remdesivir. And I think people started trading the stock around this therapeutic, which was never going to be a huge contributor to their bottom line because the government obviously was going to have so many purchases at different prices. Gilead has $25 billion of dry powder to go affect purchases and buying other R&D from biotech or small pharma. They're in a great position to grow inorganically. And they're only trading at about 13 times. They make $6 billion a year right now on about $25 billion of revenue. So we think it's an underappreciated stock that, like its competitor Amgen, has already shown a propensity for growing a well-protected dividend. We like Gilead, Stuart.
David, I've run out of time, so I can't cover IBM, but suffice it to say, it does pay a better than 5% dividend at this point, and David Barnson likes it. David, thanks for being with us. We'll see you again real soon. Promise you.